I remember when I was in high school with some of y'all younger people's age, I met with my guidance counselor. And the guidance counselor was meeting with the kids to figure out what they want to do next. And I came into the guidance counselor office, he said, little man, he said, what you want to do? I said, I want to go to college, study criminal justice, get my criminal justice degree, work in the criminal justice field. He said, excellent, Mr. Stevens, I love that. And he brought it back in his chair and he said, has anybody in your family ever gone to college? He said, my mom dropped out of high school in the 10th grade. My grandmother dropped out of high school. I think my dad did a semester in college, but he dropped out because my older brother was born. And then he sold drugs and went to prison. He said, Mr. Stevens, and he began to write. He said, our goal is to get you to graduate high school.
Oh my God.
Graduate high school? That's easy. I can do that. I said, my goal was to go to college. He said, Mr. Stevens, that's two problems. He said, number one, coming from a parent that already dropped out of high school, you're more likely to drop out of high school. The second problem is you being a male and your dad going to prison, you're more likely to go to prison. So the odds are against you. I'm not saying you can't do it. He's saying the odds are against you. I said, cool. And when I walked back to class, there was a motivation of energy that was going through me. That's what motivated me. No disrespect to my man. His statistics might have said one thing. His statistics might have said I wasn't going to college. But what was on his desk didn't say is that my mom busted her butt to make sure I ended up on campus. It didn't say that. What was not on my man's desk is that when my dad got out of prison, he started working with the youth and mentoring the youth. Did you see that homeless kid? That was my dad. It's not about what happens to you, it's how you respond to it. So when I got my high school diploma, I wish they was able to write my mom's name at the bottom of it because she deserved it just as much as I did. When I got my college degree, I wish I could have just gave it to my pops and said, Pops, I know we had to drop out because of my brother, but this is for you, Pops. When I got my badge, I wish I could have gave it to my man and said, Pops, I know you was in prison, but I'm a correctional officer now. I did the exact same officer as you did.
And